Hello, everybody. This is Chris from CSS-Tricks with video screencast number 28. This week, we are back on web forms again, and specifically, we're going to be talking about using the online service Wufoo to create forms and deal with forms through a service like them. I have to bring this up. I'm doing this because every time I bring up and talk about forms, I always mention Wufoo. People ask me about forms. What do I use for forms? How do I build? Best practices. And I'm always like, Wufoo, Wufoo. Wufoo, they're an awesome online service that provide really nice looking forms. They're really easy to customize. There's all kinds of stuff on the back end that you want out of forms. I'm going to go all about into it. I'd just like to point out this is not a paid review of Wufoo. I would take money from Wufoo if they were to give it to me, but this is not a paid review of Wufoo. It's just an introductory because I use this service so much that I just kind of wanted to introduce it to you guys too, in case you were in a position like me where you're creating forms all the time and just need it to be easier and better. So we're gonna get into a bunch of cool features and how to use Wufoo in a minute. But first, we're gonna do. I'd like to introduce you to a sponsor of this screencast, which is the WP Themer Kit. So you can Google WordPress Themer Kit or WP Themer Kit, or just go directly to their website, WPThemerKit.com, and check it out. It's a good timing for this actually, because we just kind of finished up that WordPress thing on designing for WordPress, and we were just kind of, remember, I was doing it live on the server. I was uploaded a theme, and we kind of just worked on it live, and you know, sometimes that might work for you, sometimes it might not. Sometimes it's a little nicer to build behind the scenes. And I think one of the biggest things with this WP Themer Kit allows you to do that. It does a bunch of other cool stuff too, but that's the kind of thing I want to focus on a little bit. So go ahead and check it out, and you can download it. It's free. Free to download and use. So go ahead and download it, and you'll get this folder, WPTK 1.0. And you'll see there's two folders in it. There's other files here that contains the guide, and then ABCDEF, different WordPress themes. So it'll pop open the guide, which has all kinds of documentation and stuff on how to use this theme. Basically, this is a thing to kind of help ease the building of your own themes, right? So check out this little guide here, ABCDEF. They're basically different overall layouts for your blog, different sidebars, different widths. You know, this is all customizable too once you get going, but it's kind of best to start with one of these major overall themes. So check out B here, which is a main content area, you know, header, footer, and then a fixed width 250 pixel sidebar. So let's check that one out and look at the theme, the files for the theme for that. This B, all this files, this is what every WordPress theme looks like. This is what we built in our theme. With a couple of extras in here that make this Themer Kit unique, and these are these static HTML files. Check it out. I'll open up a new tab and open up the file that says style me, blank B, style me, and we'll take a look at that. Oh, I was already in here screwing around with a little bit, but basically this is a static HTML file that uses the very same CSS file that all the files from your theme use. So I'm not on the server here. I'm just looking at this file locally on my machine, so I don't need to be running PHP, which is nice. And let's start by styling index.php. Yeah. So this is what the home page is going to look like, and this is what a single post will look like in the comments section and the comments form and pages and stuff. So I can go ahead and pop open this style.css file and change this header. Let's say I want to set it back to a more reasonable size up here and reload it. And you can see this HTML file is using this style.css file that's part of the theme. So I can style this whole thing locally, upload and activate the theme, and I'm activating a theme that I've, you know, designed and built locally. So it's kind of that CSS Zen Garden kind of thing where the theme files are how they are, and I just get to mess with this style, this CSS file, do whatever I want to it, and it all in my theme will automatically, you know, look like that. So it's designed to make designing WordPress themes easier for you. So check it out at WPThemerKit.com.